Hello students, today I will tell you about the blotting. The topic is indicates here is the hybridization, but in the next lectures I will tell you about the hybridization process. I will tell you here the basic concept of southern blotting, northern blotting and western blotting. You will see here this is a chart. According to this chart you will see here that this is a blotting compass. In this blotting compass, the northern blotting is responsible for the RNA. And you will see here the northwestern blotting is protein RNA. Protein RNA blotting is known as northwestern blotting, and western blotting is responsible for the protein. These are the scientists who has discovered to this one. And far western, it is a protein and protein combination. This blotting is for a protein to protein combination. You will see here that the southwestern blotting is protein to DNA combination. This is a electrophoretic mobility shift assay. What is this electrophoretic mobility shift assay? This is a DNA protein technique. This technique is basically for the DNA and protein. For under the southern blotting, we are the DNA, and under the southern blotting DNA, northern blotting is RNA, and western blotting is protein. Western blotting is protein. And the eastern blotting, nowadays the eastern blotting also, the post-translational modifications. Under to this eastern blotting, the post-translational modifications are studied. And here is the far eastern, this is the lipid and PTM. And here is the middle RNA to DNA, middle eastern is, under the middle eastern is RNA to DNA. This is a blotting compass. Under to this blotting compass, you can just to memorize the concept, which type of blotting is responsible for particular which. Suppose that, for example, southern blotting is responsible for the DNA, and northern blotting is responsible for the RNA, and western blotting is responsible for the proteins, and so on. Then, this is a technique that is probe. Now, what is the probe? Probe is a sequence. Probe is a sequence. Probe is a sequence of DNA sequence of 10 to 15 base pairs. Now you will see here the scientists that probe nucleic acid samples such as the fragmented genomic DNA, RNA, extract for the presence of certain sequences. So now scientists have designed a label short DNA segment. That short DNA segment is known as probe. Sometimes this probe is combined with the radioactive substances, and sometimes this probe is combined with the fluorescent dye for the detection. Fluorescent dye is better as compared to radioactive substances with the probe. Gel electrophoresis. What is gel electrophoresis? Under to the gel electrophoresis, the nucleic acid fragments are separated according to their size. Here you will see here that if the size of the molecule is light, then its movement is fast. But the size of the molecule is heavy, then the movement is slow. You will see that some scientists had thrown to this gel electrophoresis. After the gel electrophoresis, that gel electrophoresis, a gel is transferred into a nylon membrane. Nylon membrane, by procedure, that process then is called blotting. Blotting means that is a procedure by which the gel is transferred into the nylon membrane. Then the scientist can then probe the nucleic acid fragments, and that probe, that radioactively combined, either radioactively combined or fluorescent dye combined probe, detect to that sequence. For more study, you should go here. Then the scientist transfer to that DNA. Scientist transfer to that DNA which is exist in the gel to the nylon membrane. And they refer to this technique as a southern blotting. They refer to this technique as a southern blotting. When they transfer to the RNA to a nylon membrane, they call it a northern blotting. Scientists use southern blot. Scientists are using to the southern blot to detect the presence of certain DNA sequence. They use the southern blot. Why they use the southern blot? For the detection of a presence of certain DNA sequence in a given genome. In a given genome, they detect the certain DNA sequence. And in northern blot, what they are doing? In northern blot, they are detect to the gene expression. Then scientists use the southern blotting to find a particular sequence in a DNA sample, and they use the southern blotting to find a particular sequence in a DNA sample. And the scientists use DNA fragments on a gel, then they transfer to this gel into the nylon membrane, and then incubate to that specimen in a specific temperature with a DNA probe, which is the complementary to the sequence of their interest. Now, the northern blotting is similar to the southern blotting, but scientists run here is the DNA instead of the DNA. In western blot, what they are doing, they are running the proteins instead of the DNA and RNA, and they detect them by using the specific antibodies. You will see here that this is a southern blot. You will see here this is a southern blot. And under this southern blot, what you are seeing that? Under to this southern blot, you will see here that this is a gel electrode, this is a marker. Suppose that this is the ladder. This is the lightest fragments of this ladder, and this is the heaviest fragments. Now, these are the wells. From to these wells, you separate the DNA on the basis of their molecular size. If suppose that this is 100 base pairs, the sequence related to this sequence is 100 base pair in size. Now you will see the separate DNA fragments. So there you will see a smear like on this gel. When this agro gel, then you will do in a hybridization chamber. This is a hybridization buffer, and under to this hybridization buffer, this is a filter paper, and this is your nylon membrane. This is a paper towel, and you should transfer to these sequences in this nylon membrane. Then ultimately you bath to the dust. Now these fragments are coming in the nylon membrane. Then you will bath to that membrane in a solution which contains a probe. So now you will see here is that a short piece of DNA complementary sequence of interest you will see here. The probe is labeled either the fluorescent dye or the radioactive substances. Under the gel electrophore, under the gel documentation system, that specific sequence, interest of sequence will fluoresce. So by that process, you can detect your interest of sequence from to that particular DNA sample. You will see here that this is a example of the northern blotting. In this northern blotting, this is a sample. At first, what is your job is? You should go. At first, your job is, this is a sample. You should extract the RNA from to this sample in a highly sophisticated manner, because the degradation of RNA is very fast as compared to the DNA. Now, under to the electrophoresis, you can separate to this RNA. And this RNA is separated by the size again. Then what you will do? Now you should transfer to this gel in the nylon membrane again. Then you will visualize to this RNA on a X-ray film by this process. This is the labeled probe. You will see here that this is your specific sequence of RNA. Now this labeled probe will detect to that particular specific sequence. So ultimately you will visualize to this RNA molecules in a X-ray film. So what is that? This is a basic concept of the northern blotting for the RNA detection of the RNA. Here you will see here, this is a western blot. Under to this western blot, what you will do, take a cellular protein from the different conditions. Maybe sometimes these proteins will be unfold or coat with a negative charge with sodium dodecyl sulfate. This sodium dodecyl sulfate, then what you will do, your job is extract to these proteins with the help of this sodium dodecyl sulfate, then through the vertical gel, you can separate to these proteins on the basis of their molecular size. Here you will see here is a ladder, and now this is a combination of several proteins which has the similar in size. Now this is, what is this? This is your one-dimensional protein analysis. Then what you will do, then again your job is to transfer to this blot to a membrane, transfer to this blot in a membrane, then you will block with the free membrane with a generic proteins. Then you always know that these proteins are the primary antibody. The primary antibody bind to these specific proteins. The primary antibody bind to this specific antibodies, then when the there is a combination of antigen antibody reaction, then you will apply again the secondary antibody, and this secondary antibody is then this secondary antibody will bind to that complex, will bind to this antigen primary antibody complex, and you will detect. Then you can wash again. Ultimately, you will visualize to that proteins your desired interest of protein, because you are using to the specific primary antibody. So therefore, a lot of the proteins are present in the solutions. So you can detect only to those antibodies which have your interest, because you are using a specific antibodies for the detection of that specific type of the proteins. So this is the story of Western blotting, and I think that you understand to all the concept of the Southern blot, Northern blot, and Western blot. If you have any questions, you can post your questions on the discussion forum. Thank you.